Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode on Aspirant Gaming. And today we are actually back with Jack Smith. As you may have seen in the last episode of Jamie, you know, Jack's been snitching a bit. And you may be wondering where things are going for him. Well, he's actually been that's not following at all. That's creepy. Okay. She tried to lose him. I think we may have lost him. We're good. That's not suspicious at all. But technically, Jack wouldn't be able to see it. That's not suspicious at all. Well, technically Jack wouldn't be able to see him. So, eh. Let's just head down. Things have been set in motion. I gotta pull over real quick. So we just got back and Mr. Lona has a job for us, so we're gonna see what the big deal is. Just make sure that he has a gun on him, because he usually carries. Hey, what's up?
Oh, hi.
We had a job to do or something, I think, like, right?
Hey, man.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
We had, like, a job to do or something, right?
Oh, yeah. Come here.
Yeah, sure. I mean, sure thing.
The products here we need to take.
What the hell? Better stay back.
Fucking snitch.
Oh, get up. Only stab you once. Let's go. Grab the drugs. When we were to the location, the cops couldn't come here. Where'd that local go? I saw you walk into the sheriff's station, Holmes. No fucking snitches living, Holmes. Let's go.
How am I gonna put this in? Yep. Come on, see the car back here. Come on. Come on, there's another side to it. I know y'all want to. Come on, see the car back here. He doesn't see me, really.
Hello?
The thing I don't understand is why is he grabbing like Mad Pack or something and starting to treat him? Like, cause the blood is still pouring out. Chest in upper. Mm-hmm. Upper, lower. I forgot about that part. I'm kinda curious. No, that wouldn't be legit because it didn't happen.
Medics over here.
No way.
Medics, you guys are running the wrong way. It's not by my car, it's your discharger. Guys, we got multiple stab wounds in the chest area, a slit on the neck, and it looks like 13 carved in his chest.
How deep is that slit on the neck?
It stopped bleeding about a minute ago. He started turning pale. It started packing the stab wounds.
I gotta check how deep the slit on the neck is, because if it's too deep, then there's nothing we can do.
I have a feeling he might have already been gone by the time I called for you guys. He had already started turning pale, so I started trying to pack him and seeing what I could do until you guys got here.
He's becoming cooler. No.
You want me to grab the stretcher?
There's nothing we can do. No, there's nothing we can do at this point. If he's this far cold and he's getting colder at this time, there's nothing we can do. He's below
right, so
the
I
point
guess
of
I'll,
recovery.
See you down here. Yeah. I see you.
1708 declared DOA.
Mm-hmm.
I would still advise transport on the way.
Alright, I'm gonna go call for CIU. Come down here and process the scene.
Yeah, 174, we'll transport just in case.
Yeah,
to get him into the hospital.
Ma'am, next to me on my right, be careful behind you, there is a combat pistol there, I had to kick it away from the victim.
And we'll get CST to clear the scene.
Alrighty, let's grab the backboard and stretcher.
Alright, I'll stay here with him.
They should, in theory, recognize him, potentially.
I guess I called for them. Let's see how long it takes them to get down here. I'm gonna clear this weapon that was behind you.
Oh, I got yeeted. Oof. Is it? Is it Rachel? Yep. It's Rachel. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's Rachel. Yep.
I can hamper finding out the evidence. Well, I mean, if he's gone, and he's not.
Well, he was gone by the time they were there. He was getting worse. Also, okay. He did have.
Oh, so he was alive when you got to him.
Yes.
Okay, that makes a difference then. Absolutely trying to save lives.
And
did you check
also,
his pockets? Or did you just.
Yeah. Nothing but the combat pistol that's behind you. It is cleared, but the. I did
uh-huh.
clear the weapon, but it does have a filed serial number.
Okay.
I also did notice in the vehicle, as I went to try to inventory the vehicle to give you a heads up. There was cocaine in it, a blue mask, and a loaded MP5 in the trunk.
Okay. Next time, probably best to wait till we get here for that, but thank you ahead of time.
I apologize.
No, it's all good. It's just, it's best to try and preserve as much as possible once something's clearly obvious it's a homicide. Okay. I forgot.
Yeah, he had a slit in his throat when I got here, a few stab wounds, and he had M13 carved into his chest. And that's why I was trying to carve
well, that's
my
pretty much telling us who did
DC.
It. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, let's put it this way. I can't really do that much in terms of CPR and stuff when he has carving in his chest, which is why I tried to pack it.
Yeah.
But it looks like FD did mention that the slit on the neck was arterial.
So it's just 13 carved in the chest, yeah? Okay, yeah. Wow, he's been gone over quite a bit.
Looks like they went to town on him, honestly.
13 carved in chest. Exactly 13 stab wounds. Could signify rage or passion for motive. However, with 13 carved as message, likely a further symbolic meaning. Slash to neck was arterial, fatal wound. Okay, so you said he was alive when you got to him. How long ago was that?
He was alive for approximately 5 minutes before Yes arrived. I tried to preserve as much as I could. Pulse was going down and there wasn't much like it. About 15 mics by the time you got here.
Okay. Right now. So around 3:30, got it. What's your badge number, sorry?
My badge number is 235 Sierra.
Do you know who the medics were?
I believe 119, you had 213, and I forget the... I didn't catch the other person's badge number. There was three on scene.
Can you just check on the radio for me which ones turned up? I need the numbers.
Sure, not a problem.
Yeah, also, once you check with them,
on the radio.
Yeah, no, all good. Whilst you do that, do you mind grabbing? There's a fingerprint scanner in my truck. Can I go grab that for me, please? I'll see if we can get an idea. There's a print scanner in my truck. Could you go grab that whilst you check which medics
scanner?
It was? Just, we could find out his ID.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, no problem.
Thank you, but found a wallet, so we're good with that regard.
Oh, okay. I apologize. The radio.
No. It's absolutely fine. Don't worry. No, absolutely fine. Don't worry.
All right,
phone here, so
I'm gonna go
to grab a warrant for this. Yeah, no worries. I'll be with you in just 1 second. I need to go quickly file a warrant for that phone.
Okay, and just to let you know, it's 145, 119, and 2.
Oh my god, the raptor. Oh my god.
See when I get that back.
174.
Copy, I'll catch it.
Yeah, it was 174 that was BLS, 119 was ALS, and 213 was engine.
Did we run the plate on this thing?
Nope.
What was that?
Did we run the plate on the car?
Negative. I wanted to wait until you got here at that point.
Use my truck if you don't mind. Tell me if it comes back to Mr. Smith. 85 okay. ISH 215.
85 ISH 215?
Yep, that's it.
Alright, I'm gonna write it on my notepad.
Now this area is going to be pretty contaminated, but let's see what we can find. Hey, can you get some march units to deal with those two up there? Tell them to back off. Actually, do you mind telling those two bikers behind you?
Oh, yeah. I can.
Up on the hillside. Yeah, just get them to back off, please. It's a crime scene.
Okay.
Just let them know if they come any closer.
Yeah, like I said, though, the plate doesn't come back.
Doesn't? It should come back, so that doesn't... I think he ran it wrong. Alex, what's gonna be in the tent?
What?
What's gonna be in that tent where we fought?
Residue of drugs, but there's no product in there. Just residue.
Mm-hmm. Come on. Hey, Sian.
Hey.
What car were you guys driving?
Stanier, I think.
Okay. Use that knife from about 5 centimeters deep and about 3 centimeters in length. Because technically that's quite deep.
Hey, 403. I think I have something you might be interested in.
Yeah?
So, you know those two bikers that were on top of the hill that we asked to back off? So, they witnessed a blue sedan driving away from this area, and they have GoPro footage. They have GoPro footage with a actual plate number.
Shit. Really?
Yeah, I have the SD card right here.
Amazing. Thank him for me. We'll give them back in a second. I need to copy it, though.
Yeah. I got the plate number also written down in my book. Yeah. Here you go. It's going to be 28 Mary George 5513.
28 Mary George 5513.
Yep. They said when they caught it speeding out of here, and I don't know if you see it in the footage, but they were they said what looks like to them that they were going approximately 145 miles an hour away from here. They were speeding away from here. Because they were coming down the trails, and then that's
when
they
saw the vehicle. Was that 2.5, Mary Juliet?
2.8MG5513.
Interesting.
Okay, here's the card. You give that back to them and tell them thank you from me. I've got a copy of it.
Okay. Yeah, I definitely figured once they saw something, I'm like, you know what, I think the detective might be interested in this.
Men and women, wearing all black, female, had a few tattoos, bingo, we're getting more and more information here.
Yep, and that definitely was help.
You know, just some communicating, that way, you know, like, we're not in actual planning room. Cause, you know, there's not, like, a way to coordinate this, so... Yeah?
I got an idea.